In this video, we're going to take a look at two new keywords, offset and limit. These are two keywords that are pretty straightforward, so we're just going to spend one video on them. I think you'll understand them rather quickly. We make use of offset anytime that we want to skip some number of records in a result set. So let's imagine that we write out a query to fetch all of our different products, all the different rows, and all the different columns. If we applied an offset of 3, that means that we would want to skip over the first 3 records, and we would only get back the remaining ones. Let's take a look at an example of offset right away. So back over here, I'm going to first take a look at the number of users in our users table. So I'm going to do a select count star from users. It looks like we have 50 users in total. Let's now try to fetch all the different rows and columns of our users table, but I only want to see the last 10 users. So to do so, we could write out select star from users, and then I would offset by 40. That means skip the first 40 users and only show us the last 10. So now if we run that query, we can see very easily we get back results starting at an ID of 41 and then going up to 50. That's pretty much it for offset. It just means skip some number of rows from our result set. Limit is somewhat similar in nature. It is going to constrain the number of records we get back from the result of a query. Limit, in particular, is going to make sure that we only take some specific number of records out of the result set. You are frequently going to see limit and offset being used together. So let's imagine what would happen if we applied a limit of 2 and an offset of 3. First, the offset of 3 means that we want to skip the first 3 records. A limit of 2 means that we only want to take the first 2 rows out of the remaining results. So we would drop off all the remaining rows of 6 and 7, and we are left with just 4 and 5. We do not have to use limit with offset. We can use limit by itself. Let's take a look at using limit by itself and then try combining offset and limit together. Okay, so once again, I'll do a select star from users, and I'm going to limit 5. That should give us just the first 5 users of our users table. So I see users with ID 1 through 5. We can go all the way down to a limit of 1. We can do a limit of 50. That's how many users we have in the table, so this effectively is the same as just fetching all of our users. We can also specify a limit greater than the number of records we have, and nothing bad is going to happen. If you have fewer records than you have of the limit right here, you're not going to get an error. You're just going to receive or retrieve all the different rows that are available. All right, so let's now try applying limit and order together. I want to try to order all of my different products by price. I then want to retrieve the 5 least expensive products. So to do so, we can do a select star from products. I'm going to order by all these things by price. By default, we get an ascending order here. So if we run this just by itself, we'll see that we get all the least expensive products first. So we could then apply a limit of 5, and that will give us our 5 least expensive products. If we want to see the 5 most expensive, we could do a different sort of order here of descending. That means we'll see the most expensive products first. Yep, there we go. So there's our 5 most expensive products. If we wanted to, say, find the 5 most expensive products, except for the most expensive one, we could then apply an offset after the limit. So I'd apply offset right here of, say, 1. That means that we would skip the first row and then only take the next 5. So if I run that, now the ID of 80 is gone and we see the next 5 after it. If you ever make use of limit and offset together, you will place the limit first and then the offset. Technically, it can work either way. You can put offset first, but by convention, we put limit first. All right, so that is it for limit and offset. Now, you might be curious, where would we ever use these? Well, there's two scenarios in which we would use them. First, you might use just limit by itself anytime that you want to find the top record of something, or maybe the top 5 or something like that. And we just saw an example of that. The query that we have right here, where we make use of order by, is going to give us the 5 most expensive records. If we remove the descending, then we get the 5 least expensive records. If we wanted just the least expensive record, we could do a limit of 1, and now we can see information about the least expensive record overall. That's limit by itself, but where would we use offset? Well, like I said, limit and offset are frequently used together. A very common use of limit and offset together is any time that you're working with a large set of records that you want to display to a user. So our fake database right here has 550 different products in it. But across the world, there's companies like Amazon where they have millions of products. In some cases, there might be just too much information to show to a user on one single screen. So you might want to only show a user, say, 20 records at a time. To do so, we could apply an offset and a limit. Let's say that we want to only show a user 20 records at a time. To do so, we would apply a limit of 0, or excuse me, a limit of 20, and an offset of 0. This would give us our first page of information, a first page of results to show to a user. So now a user is only seeing 20 records here, which in general is enough or small enough a data set to be parsed by a user. We could then present them with a button that allowed them to go to a next page of results. If a user ever clicked that, we could then do a follow-up query, and we can increase the offset by 20. So now we're saying skip the first 20 records and only show the next 20. So we can run this, and now we're only seeing the next 20. We can then go to an offset of 40 and continue on down. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Well, let's take a quick pause right here and go through a quick exercise in just a moment.